This is my wrist-mounted data pad used by Dactyril. And this is a mini computer device that does just about anything you want it to. It does everything. It's a computer, it's a hacking device. You can use it to gain access to computer consoles with it and hack the Imperial network with it. And it's used for downloading data and information. It's also got a comlink built into it so it can communicate with anyone. It's got a hologram projector and recorder in it, so he can record hologram messages or communicate with other characters via hologram messages. And it's a recording device, and he can open lock doors with it and everything. It's the Force Link toy thingamajig. And seeing as it's Star Wars related, I thought it can be used as an in-character prop. But does yours do this? No, yours doesn't do that. Mine does. It's got a built-in hologram projector, so mine can do all kinds of really cool stuff like that. I bet yours doesn't. I spray painted it white and then dry brushed it with black brushing paint and added some gunmetal details and made it weathered and makes it look really, really nice. This is the original computer data pad that was used before I got the wrist mounted version. It basically does the same thing, it's just a handheld version. It's got a built in hologram projector and recorder. It has a built in comlink so characters can communicate with each other. It's got a working screen. It actually does have a working screen when you put batteries in it and turn it on. The screen actually functions and does things. It's basically an electronics game. I think it was started life as a Pokemon thing, but I turned it into a Star Wars prop. Actually, I can use it for anything. I can use this as a Doctor Who prop. I can use it in any kind of sci-fi setting I want. It looks like a sci-fi gizmo or gadget. It could be like a tricorder, data recording device, or anything. It has working buttons. It actually makes bleepy noises when you turn it on. I spray painted it in metallic gunmetal grey and then dry brushed it with chrome brushing paint to weather the edges, make it look like it's been on a few adventures. It looks really good as a original sci-fi prop. I can use it for anything I wanted to. And this is the actual one that's used in my Star Wars film. It's actually screen used. When Dactyril is communicating with the Jedi, he uses this. This is my Star Wars comlink. It's a communicator and it looks like a Star Wars prop. It's actually obviously the top half of a broken Doctor Who sonic screwdriver. I just found it in a junk shop, thought I'll buy the parts and use it for something, and decided to turn it into a Star Wars communicator. And it looks like a Star Wars communicator now. It fits in the pocket, fits in any pouch. I spray painted it metallic grey, gunmetal grey with chrome details, and it looks good as just a simple Star Wars communicator. I decided that my Rebel Hero character Dactyril needs more gadgets and gizmos and greeblies and thingamajigs. You know, I need to fill out my leather pouch with all kinds of props to represent these gadgets and gizmos that he has. And this is it actually looks like a communicator. It could be a communicator, but I've already got a communicator for that character. So this is now a data storage device. This is a mini computer. It's got a built-in hologram projector on it, so it can display information, images or video footage. And it's like the Star Wars equivalent of a flash drive. So it's used for storing information, and maybe he's got top secret information on it and the villains are searching for it. This could be the plot of a movie, so the villains could be searching for this with important vital information on it. Maybe it's got a map on it, you know, it could be a map to a top secret Jedi sacred site on an ancient lost planet somewhere that they could be searching for it, and it becomes the plot of a movie. It's just junk I was going to throw away. And I spray painted it in gunmetal grey and then dry brushed it with chrome brushing paint on the edges to weather it and make it look like it's really old and battered. You know, it could be a relic from the Clone Wars. You know, it could be a... It could have Jedi secrets on here that they don't want to fall into the hands of the Sith. You know, they don't want it falling into the hands of the Empire. And Dak Terrell has this upon him, and he doesn't know what he's got is vitally important. Might have really long-lost Jedi secrets on here. And villains could be searching the galaxy for it, and he makes sure it doesn't fall into their hands. It looks like a Star Wars gizmo, so... Every Star Wars character should have a pair of macro binoculars, and this is my one. This is basically the toy version. I painted it. I did it in metallic grey with chrome details. I sealed it up with glue so you can't open it anymore. And then did lots of nice weathering. I dry brushed it. I just watered down some black paint and blobbed it on with a brush, and it came up looking absolutely fantastic. The weathering on this, I dry brushed it with some silver brushing paint as well, so it looks like it's worn. It's been battered, it's been bashed around, you know, it's really, really old. But then what I did to it, the last thing I did to it was add these mirrors. Oh, there's the camera. I got these round mirrors from a craft shop. A bag of them really cheap, and I thought, oh, it needs lenses. The macro binoculars need some kind of lenses, so I super glued these mirrors on the front of them to represent the lenses, so now it looks like a proper pair of binoculars. It looks really nice now. Okay, obviously this is a Doctor Who sonic screwdriver, but seeing as I've got loads of sonic screwdrivers in my sonic screwdriver collection, I decided I can recycle them and use them as other props in other franchises. Lots of people do that anyway. So I have this in Dak Terrell's tool collection. It's part of his toolkit. Because he doesn't own a droid, he needs all different kinds of gadgets and gizmos for doing different kinds of things. This is just a repairing device. This is a cutting tool, really. It's more like a blowtorch device used for repairing and maintaining spaceships. It's used for cutting through metal. You can use it for getting through doors, opening locked doors, opening up control panels, repairing his ship, making basic repair jobs. And it's basically a cutting torch, and he uses it for all kinds of different things. He carries it up on him everywhere he goes, and if he needs to get open a control panel or a blast door, he can get into it pretty quickly and efficiently with this. Many of the Star Wars computer games, such as Shadows of the Empire and Dark Forces, you have to find a key card to open locked doors. That's basically what this thing is. This can be used as a movie prop. Say, for example, the characters come to a locked door, they need the key card to open the door, and that's what this could be. It's just a gubbins, it's just a greebly. It started life as a pair of binoculars, and I got rid of the binoculars years ago and kept this section and just spray painted it in metallic copper colours and then dry brushed it with black on top so it looks metallic. It's just a gubbins, it's a greebly, it's a thingamabob, and it can be used for just about any kind of prop. In my Star Wars film, you can see Rogan the Fearless using his own thermal detonators. And this is the prop from the actual film. This is the actual screen used prop of the thermal detonator he uses when he comes under attack by two Jedi Knights. I spray painted it metallic grey and then extra layers of chrome on top to make it more silvery, so it's very dark silver, and then dry brushed it with black to weather it. You might recognise it. It started life as a model of a Jedi starfighter. The wings broke off eventually, it became more and more damaged. I deliberately snapped it apart and used a hacksaw to chop it to pieces. So this is just the cockpit section. And I thought, hey, it looks like thermal detonator-ish. So I decided to use it as a thermal detonator because it started life as a Star Wars thing to begin with. It's perfect. So you can actually see it being activated. You're pressing a fake button on it and then throwing it, and then seeing two Jedi Knights running away from the resulting explosion. So it looks good as a villain's thermal detonator, just as it is. This one is a very big proton pulse bomb. It actually started life as a Batman grapple gun, but I decided to recycle it and turn it into a Star Wars prop. It's a very big thermal detonator. It's actually a remote controlled mine with the power of four thermal detonators inside it. And if you place it in a power generator room inside a Imperial Star Destroyer, you can take out the entire Star Destroyer. That's how powerful it is. It's basically the same ones that you see in the Star Wars films. You see them in Return of the Jedi. They're planting explosive devices all over the Imperial bunker, and they blow up the entire bunker. They destroy the entire shield generator. That's basically what this is used for. It's used for destroying Imperial bases. It's used for taking out large-scaled battleships. You can take out a Trade Federation droid control ship with this thing. You know, if you place it in the right place, you plant them all over the ship. Or plant it near the power generator core, because you can destroy an entire ship with it. I spray painted it metallic black. I did flat black to start with, and then a very fine mist of chrome spray paint on top to make it metallic, and then dry brushed it with black on top of that to weather it and age it.